Hello and welcome to Praying Parents, and I'm your host Pamela Shea, and we're here to talk about praying for students and children among our own children, nieces, nephews, grandchildren, and young friends. Because when we pray, God hears and he moves the hearts of those we love, and he intercedes, and we intercede because we are obedient to God. So today I'd like to welcome my guest, Selena Fletcher, from Steubenville, Ohio. Hello, Selena. How are you?
Good morning. I'm well. How are you?
Just great. I'm really glad to have you here today. And we're going to go through just chatting about prayer, and we're going to pray a little bit as well. There are many wonderful ways to pray, but what I'm finding that's useful for this show is to use the acronym ACTS, Adoration, Confession, Thanksgiving, and Supplication. So we're going to begin with adoring our Lord, our God, praising him for who he is, his name, and his character. And today I'd just like to focus on the fact that God is faithful. He is reliable. He's constant. So let's pray together. Dear Lord, oh, Almighty God, Heavenly Father, we praise you because you are reliable. You are constant. You are loyal, unwavering, steadfast, and dependable. Oh, Lord God, Heavenly King, we praise you. Psalm 33 says, your word, Lord, is right and true, and you are faithful in all you do. Psalm 45, O Lord, praises you because your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. O God, your dominion endures through all generations. Lord, we praise you because you are trustworthy. You make your promises, you keep your promises, and you are faithful in all that you do. And through Lamentations 3, Lord, we praise you because by your great love we are not consumed. Your compassion never fails us. Your compassion for us is renewed every morning. Your faithfulness is so great. Lord, you are our portion, and we will wait for you. Amen.
Amen.
So, Selena, so I brought you here to talk about prayer and how you've been praying for children and young friends for many, yes, many years. And what brought you to pray for other people, especially youngsters?
Well, in being the mother of six, you kind of fall into that. You learn that prayer is what changes things, you know. And I've always prayed for my kids. And so as your kids are grown and they're bringing other kids in and out and they're coming into your home, you learn to pray for them because they start confiding in you about certain things and situations that they're going through. So you just automatically begin to add those kids into. And just with our world today, our young people need our prayers. They definitely need our prayers. Young people today are going through so much more than what I ever dreamed. I don't know where I would be had I had to go through some of the things, the peer pressures and things, you know, that go on today. So that's where I started praying for other people, their children. And these young people are our future. You know, we're not always gonna be here. And we want to pray over them that God would lead, guide, and direct them, you know, because they need it, definitely need it, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And have you seen specific needs among kids over the years? Because your parenting has spanned a number of years.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah.
Have you seen certain great needs?
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, it's amazing at the things that you hear in just your kids being around other kids, and the things that you hear come out of their mouth, even when they, if they don't know you're listening or sometimes, because I could be in the kitchen cooking and you're hearing, as a mom, you have ears everywhere.
Yeah.
And you're hearing the conversations, you know, and I don't always jump in. I wouldn't always jump in. I just listen to see, you know, exactly what's going on. And, you know, we can always kind of, as parents and as adults, we can voice what we feel, how we feel, or we as adults have the authority over the children, you know. But sometimes kids need to be able just to voice how they feel. It may not always come out the way we want to hear it, but listening is a key. It's a key. It took me years to learn that. Because I, as a parent, you know, there's no perfect parent. I wasn't a parent before my first child. So certain things I remember telling him, no, don't say that to me. I'm your mom. Or he's trying to voice. It was my second child. My second child, he had a voice. He was going to say what he was going to say, the way he was going to say it. And there were many barriers up because I wouldn't listen, because I didn't like the way, the tone of voice, the way he was expressing himself. But when you learn how to listen to them, they're angry too. Kids get angry too, you know. Us as adults, we have the authority. When we're angry, we can say what we want to say, and they dare not say nothing in response, but we want to shut them down. But when I learned how to listen, I learned how to pray. You learned what to pray for. He's angry and he's saying this, and this. And then as you learn how to pray about the situation, God will connect with you. So you will not only, I've learned that even praying for my kids, I've learned that some things I needed to change. God touched my heart and let me see my part in why he was angry, you know. So, yeah, I've learned how to pray different things, even for other people's kids that can't voice to their parents. For some reason, they feel like, well, I can say this to Miss Selena. I can talk to her or whatever. And, you know, you get an opportunity to witness to those kids. In some homes, most homes, they are not getting that godly. They're not getting that spiritual side. So that's opportunity for me to plant a seed. And kids, you know them, they take the seed back home. You give them a little bit, they take it back home. And so then, you know, I've actually experienced kids, they start coming to church, then their parents start coming to church. Or their parents start asking. And it may be over years, but God is doing what he do. The seed is planted, some water it, and then it take root, it fall on. Eventually that heart open up and it fall on good soil and it's got to grow. It's the word of God.
He's been faithful to his promises, and that word that went out did not come back without
amen.
The water and the seeds and the growth
amen.
And the new life.
Yes, yes.
God is
yes.
gracious and faithful. So let's just pause now to confess our sins personally in our minds to
yes.
God, who forgives. 1 John says, if we confess our sins, he's faithful and righteous to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So I'm going to ask Trey to play a little bit of quiet music in the background as I invite my listeners to quietly confess sins to our God who forgives us.
Just don't know how. all pour out. And though I'm silent, my heart is crying, 'cause I was made to come to you.
Hello, welcome back. We just had our time of confessing our personal sins to the God who forgives. And this is Pamela Shea, and this is the show Praying Parents. And we're following a simple format of prayer, which is the acronym ACTS: Adoration, Confession, Thanksgiving, and Supplication. And so now we're going to thank God for what he's done, without making any requests during this time. 1 Thessalonians reminds us, in everything give thanks, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. And I am here with my guest, Selena Fletcher, today. Hello, Selena.
Hello, hello.
So I'm wondering if you could join me in our next portion, Thanksgiving and Supplication, and just to really to in thanking God for prayers answered, all these years that you've been praying for, mm-hmm. for kids and for students, mm-hmm. and for young friends. Are there any things that come to mind that when you prayed and you saw results and you said to yourself, wow, that was the Lord?
Yes, yes. You know, in praying, I'll tell you a big one, and it's so funny.
Please do, yes.
I have been praying for years for prayer to get back into schools.
Oh.
Because there just really floored me that one person can get prayer taken out of schools. You know, if you don't have prayer, what coverage do you have over kids, over you, over anything? And that, I'm telling you, is the biggest thing that we have. When I went to school, we had the Bible as literature. That
you
was something
did.
That I had to take.
Now, that was years ago.
It was years ago. Oh, yeah, it was years
ago. And then what happened?
But I'm telling you, they took it out. They took the prayer out. I remember the Gideons would come around and give us a little red New Testament. That was just what we expected every year. I remember starting school, we would say the Lord's Prayer. We would do the Pledge of Allegiance and sing the song and all that. And then to not have my kids do that, mm-hmm. and my grandkids not experience that, it was scary. That's scary, but so that is like the biggest thing to see, that prayer's back in the school. The Bible is literature. When I heard that, I was just God is awesome. I'm sitting here like getting chills because like it's awesome because watch the change.
Wow.
Watch the change. You know, we all talk about this area being a darkened area and it has a cloud over it and all that, but prayer is what changed things. And seeing that prayer is back in the school system, there's going to be, and believe me, the devil, he's mad, so he's definitely going to be doing some things, but prayer always overcome. The word of God always overcome, and that to me is the biggest, because I've prayed for years, God, please let prayer get back in school. Let them have that Bible class back in school, because that's what helped me. When kids can't get that at home, to come to school and be able to get that, that's the foundation. It gives foundation. And these little people, now they need it more than ever. They need it. So that, and even just the peace I've seen in my own family, you know, things coming, man, things coming together with my kids, you know. I've prayed for salvation. I've prayed for, and it's so funny how, as a mother, you say, are these kids picking up anything that I'm laying down?
Mm-hmm.
Because you see them going all crazy and astray, and you're like, that's not even what I taught them.
Mm-hmm.
But to see God bringing it into full circle to what He do things when He do what He do in His time. You know, we got an agenda and we have a time that we want stuff done. But God said, no, it's going to happen in my time. And even though I would see them go, even now, certain things I'll see them go. But now I hear certain little conversations. My oldest son called me, Mom, I'm going to call you back so we can pray.
Wow.
That is a mind blower there.
Wow. Yes,
I'm telling
absolutely.
You, it really is. So it gives me hope. That, you know, I know God is hearing my prayers. And I don't care what it may look like with my naked eyes, with my natural eyes. But my spiritual eyes know that my God is faithful. Yes. And when He called me and told me that, and it wasn't nothing going on, because they all want to call you when something crazy going on in their life. They want to call,
yes.
Mom, can we pray?
You know?
Yeah. Or I need you to pray. But wasn't nothing going on. He just said, I'm going to call you so we can do this, so we can pray. So I'm looking forward to it. That was a prayer answer. And I know it had to be God for that one. That
yes.
particular son, oh, it had to be God.
Oh,
had to be God. He's awesome.
That
he
is wonderful. So I'm curious, with the prayer not being in the schools, how many years were you pleading with God to get prayer back in the schools?
Let me see. My oldest is, he'll be 31 years old. And it's been at least, because I don't think they handed them the Bibles in school.
Oh.
Yeah, clear back in, let me see. Wow, I've been praying for, I know, 15, 20 years.
Wow.
I know, yeah.
Just faithfully pressing in.
Yes, just praying and
praying.
And God, you've got to do this. You know, we need you to do this. And you know God answers, but when you don't see it happening right away, you know, and it, like I said, in His timing, things come in full circle. But that's a big one for me to see. Oh, my God. And the people that God choose to use is so funny, because it just like blow your mind, because you think, well, it's going to go this way. Or, you know, we have our own little, when we ask God to do something, we got handpicked people that, well, that person would be the person to be able to get this done, or that person. Nope, not at all. Not at all. These are people who God had down the way I never even knew. And, you know, it's just, God is amazing. And yes, He is still in the prayer business, the miracle working, prayer answering business. Yes,
wow.
He is. Yes.
Yeah.
He's faithful. We have to learn to be faithful. Because he is faithful. He can't lie, you know.
Yeah.
He can't turn away. It's us. We have to learn how to, even when it look crazy, be faithful to it. Be faithful to it and look at God's work. Look at what He's doing in these schools. The breakthrough.
Yes.
It's amazing.
Yeah, it is. It is amazing what God is doing in this
it's amazing.
Area. And I just like what you're saying, time and again, different people are saying, oh, I've been praying for these schools for years and years, and it's finally, I guess it started about 5 years ago with the first Bible weekly Bible studies that got legally passed through the administration. God has just been answering prayers of so many people, just like you're saying, praying for 20 years faithfulness in tears, sowing seeds in tears, and now we're starting to see not new life and God's blessing.
Yes.
Yeah, I am so very thankful to be in this season.
Amen. And what's really awesome is to see the flock of kids. They're hungry. They want it. It's, you know, it's almost like when you see, and I see the postings of the kids that are, you know, there and showing up for these Bible studies and stuff, they want it. They are ready and to receive, because, you know, God said in these days he's going to pour his Spirit out, you know, and he's pouring his Spirit out everywhere. We feel it. We know it. So just, it's amazing.
It is.
This army is ready.
Yes, yes. Like the Lord is raising up an army.
Yes, he is.
And
yes.
He's just doing wonderful things. So, wow. So we have so much to thank God for. Would you like to come together with me for supplication on behalf of others, and maybe pick a student or a child? And I invite the listeners to also join. And I'm just going to throw in a young person's name here that I will add. And I'm going to pray for my young friend, actually, Monica. Let Monica know that no temptation has seized her except what's common to man. And you, God, are faithful. You will not let Monica be tempted beyond what she can bear, but when she's tempted, you will also provide a way out so that Monica can stand up under it. So Lord, I just ask you to bless Monica, and I ask you to keep her in the palm of your hand in all the decisions that she makes and the choices that she does in yes. one season to the next. Yes. Amen.
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 And we also have teachers and school staff in our children's circle of influence, people who influence them and influence their peers. And so I'd just like to invite you also to pray with me, Lord. I just ask that the teachers and staff in this region will be blessed by you, and that also that they will know that you are faithful, and do
yes.
not let our teaching professionals and staff be tempted beyond what they can bear, but also provide a way out for them so that they can stand up under temptation, Lord. And for school concerns, Lord, I just ask you for greater revival and greater spiritual awakening on the school campuses, especially in the region of Steubenville, Wintersville,
yes. Yes.
Mingo, Edison, Weirton, and all the schools in this Ohio Valley region. Amen.
Amen.
And
Amen.
Would you like to join in
yes.
in prayer?
Sure.
If you'd like to lead
sure.
us in anything.
Sure.
Thank you.
Father, I just come to you today, Lord, just thanking and praising you for all things, oh God. And Lord, I thank you, God, for our school systems, oh Lord. I thank you for your Holy Spirit that leads, guides, and directs, oh God. I thank you. I thank you for the hearts that you've touched, God, in our school systems. I thank you for opening up the hearts for them to receive, so that we would have these Bible studies, that we would have these prayer meetings with the children, not only just in our school systems, God, but Lord, I'd like to pray for the colleges, the kids that are away at college, oh God, that you would just protect them, God, protect them, because when we get away from home, sometimes we don't always stay grounded, but Lord, I ask that you would just protect each and every student, God, and even these crazy shootings and things, God, I ask that you would just heal those areas, those places where the shootings have taken place, and just heal, comfort those families, oh God, even those students, God, that's been there and has suffered such a, experienced a, great tragedy, such a bad experience, Lord. I just ask that your peace, oh God, would overcome, that your peace would be there amongst them, Lord, and that they would become more prayerful and unite together in your name, God, we just thank you. We praise you for each and every adult, God, that has something to do with this, and continue, God, to let your will be done in our community and in our school system. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. And Lord, I just want to come into agreement with Selena just for greater response to the weekly Bible studies that are being offered in schools, Lord, all over this area, and also a greater presence of the gospel in the colleges, campuses, Lord, the dorms, the households in this area also, Lord. I just ask you to cover every school in prayer, Lord, and draw up parents and concerned adults to cover every school in prayer. And Lord, I just ask you to please protect all praying parents. Keep the parents and the adults who pray untarnished and pure and persistent. Lord, help us to come into greater agreement so that we can pray in unity and faith through Jesus Christ in the Holy Spirit. And Lord, I just also want to ask you to bless us and help us to petition, pray, intercede, and give thanks on behalf of ourselves, and especially on behalf of the children and students and teachers and staff in this area. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Well, thank you so much, Selena.
Oh,
it has been great chatting with you.
Thanks
for joining me.
Yes.
Thank you also, listeners, for joining us on Praying Parents. And I'm your host, Pamela Shea, and look forward to talking next time. God bless you.